Secretary Clinton, Vice Chancellor Westerwelle, President Kempe, Excellencies, distinguished guests, thank you very much, Tom Brokaw, for your kind words, for that moving introduction. On behalf of all Berliners, I would like to thank the Atlantic Council of the United States for this Freedom Award. I'm deeply honored to be able to accept this award on behalf of the people of Berlin. We have just seen the familiar images of the fall of the Berlin Wall. They brought back the happiest moment in Berlin's history. The wall had separated families, friends, and neighbors for decades. And on the night of November 9, 1989, they were reunited. Our happiness and rejoicing knew no bounds. The GDR rulers had locked up and oppressed the population. But the longing for freedom and democracy proved to be stronger than the wall and state censorship. Wolf Biermann, a well-known critic of the GDR regime and one of Berlin's honorary citizens, has said, "We were few in number and we were afraid." But the desire for freedom was greater than their fear. A few individuals led the way in the GDR, in Poland, in the Soviet Union, in Hungary and in Czechoslovakia. Lech Wałęsa and Václav Havel have also been honored tonight. Both of them are extraordinary freedom fighters, and Berlin salutes them. Their actions gave people in East Berlin the courage to overcome their fears and to take to the streets in support of freedom, and not only in Berlin and in the GDR. The peaceful revolution of 1989 was a freedom movement that spread throughout Europe, and it helped to speed up the process of European integration. My thanks also go to the United States of America. It has always been a loyal friend to Berlin, and that is especially true of the difficult years when the city was divided by the Iron Curtain. After 13 years of Nazi dictatorship and barbarism, America brought Berlin peace and freedom. America played a decisive role in making West Berlin an island of freedom and democracy. America's presidents condemned the wall and were committed to achieving freedom for people in East Berlin and the GDR. President John F. Kennedy encouraged and inspired the people of Berlin when he stood in front of the Schöneberg Town Hall in 1963 and said, "All free men, wherever may they live, are citizens of Berlin, and therefore, as a free man, I take pride in the words, 'Ich bin ein Berliner.'" On November 9, 1989, free people everywhere were citizens of all of Berlin. Once the wall had fallen, it was the American President George Bush Sr. who supported the reunification of Berlin and Germany clearly and unconditionally on behalf of the American people. Without American support, the reunification of Germany and Berlin would still be only a dream. The people of Berlin know that, and that is why they are grateful to the United States for everything it has done for the city. We will always remember Americans' commitment to this city, especially on historic dates like November 9th, the day the wall fell 20 years ago. Our close transatlantic ties live on in the activities of countless networks and organizations. And the Atlantic Council of the United States make a vital contribution to these. The fact that these Freedom's Challenge Awards are being presented here in Berlin on the eve of the 20th anniversary of the fall of the wall is a great honor to the city. Berlin has taken advantage of its historic opportunity. The formerly divided city has grown together. 20th 21st century Berlin is an exciting metropolis and the place to be for people from all over the world, especially for young people. We are very proud of this development, and tomorrow we will celebrate it before the eyes of a watching world with a marvelous festival of freedom at Brandenburg Gate. At the same time, we know how great a role our friends in America and in Europe played in this miraculous development. In this spirit, I would like to thank the Atlantic Council for this distinguished award. Thank you very much.